Well, the race for the World Series crown is down to 8, and a capacity crowd is in postseason form as we get you ready for this one. It's game one of the National League Division Series between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the St. Louis Cardinals. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vasgersian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, let's take a look at how these two ball clubs got to where they are.
Yeah, and top to bottom, I think both of these clubs have a lot of different guys that can beat you. It might not just be the stars that dominate this series. It wouldn't surprise me a bit if some of the lesser-known guys here wind up stealing the show.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Back now live as we count down to the start of game one. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci. Briefly now, we'll look at the two starters who get the ball here in game one. More from the guys moving forward this afternoon, but first, let's get a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Pittsburgh Pirates, as manager Clint Hurdle has his squad lined up like this. And getting his final warm-up tosses in, the starter who they'll be up against, as you see his totals there on the right side of your screen. And the Cardinals behind him will look like this defensively. Jose Tabata will head for the box as we are just about ready to get things going today. And the first pitch of the afternoon is taken for ball one, and we're underway in St. Louis. Left it up in the zone, but it's a strike, 1-1. Should be a picture-perfect afternoon for baseball. 78 degrees at first pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here's the pitch. And a fastball is swung on and missed, and there is your first out of the contest. So Tabata retired to lead things off, and with that, let's take a look at the defensive lineup for the Redbirds. It's brought to us by the folks at Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. Neil Walker digs in at the plate. First pitch to him. fairly generous strike call there on a pitch that looked off the plate. It's strike one. Swing and a miss as Walker's in a hole here. No balls and two strikes.
You can tell he's still frustrated after that first called strike. That's still on his mind.
And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Very sharp here to these first two hitters. Back-to-back strikeout. It doesn't look like it took him long to settle in here at home.
Andrew McCutchen will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Swing and a miss for strike one. Just getting started here in St. Louis. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
This has been just the kind of start you hope for in a game one.
And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. He'll try again, 1-2. Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and his side is retired. So not much happening here in the top half of the first. And now the Cardinals get their first shot at it here. No score. Now the starting lineup for the Cardinals looks like this. And this lineup will have to contend with no easy assignment indeed. The man with the electric slider, left-hander Francisco Liriano. And a look now at how the Pirates line up on D behind him. John Jay will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Boy, he is just wearing guys out with that two-seam fastball. I don't care if it's inside, outside, he's really hitting his spots well.
Right back with another fastball, it's 0-2 now.
And now, I wouldn't be surprised at all to see this next one be a changeup in the dirt.
Fouled straight back. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one. Matt Carpenter will take his cuts now. swing and a miss on the slider, nothing and one. And now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to fairly deep right field. Therefore, it is Bird now as he's got it for out number two. And with two away now, let's give you a look at the big picture here. There you see the participants in the 2013 postseason. Alan Craig will get his first opportunity now with two away, and the base is empty here in the home half of the first. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. And Craig is aboard here. It's a base hit.
First base runner of the ball game now for either team comes with two outs here in the home first. Now, with the cleanup guy due next, things all of a sudden could get a bit interesting.
Matt Holliday will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And he committed to that one a bit too soon as it locks him up for strike one. He waits. Now the pitch. And Holliday swings and misses and falls behind quickly, nothing and two.
Down 0-2 after two great sliders. He's got his work cut out for him now.
In the air, down the left field line and deep. Habita will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Redbirds are turned away in the first. We're on to the second from St. Louis. Scoreless. Pedro Alvarez leads things off now in the top half of the second. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Trying to jump on that first pitch changeup. That's a good pitch there to start this AB.
And here's a fastball called for strike two.
Wow, he is spotting that fastball on a dime here early on.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's one and two.
Good changeup right there, down in the strike zone. Definitely the one they wanted to strike him out on, so that's a great job to lay off.
And he will keep it going on the mound. He struck out the side last time through. Now the streak hits four in a row, one away. Garrett Jones will dig in here. High strike there, 0-1. The pitch. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
He's found a pretty nice rhythm out here early on.
And this is strike three called. Make it five straight punch-outs. Two away now.
Wow, he just never got into the rhythm of that at-bat at all. I mean, normally, you'd expect a middle-of-the-order guy to put up a little more fight than that, wouldn't you? And he just got caught flat-footed on all three of those pitches.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in now is Marlon Byrd. Now here's the first pitch. And this ball will be chopped foul. On the ground towards second. Oh, and he can't come up with it.
This will happen when you don't square your shoulders to the baseball. And this one catches him kind of at an angle here. And the result, a two-out base runner.
So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring in the all-star catcher, Russell Martin. In tight here with the first pitch fastball, that's 1-0.
He knows he should be out of the inning already, but you know, he's got to pick up his defender behind him and get out of this.
And there he goes towards second. Is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch, and they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Bird off second. Now the pitch. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. To two balls and two strikes now. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. 3-2 now.
Well, that's an opportunity wasted on the mound there. Well, a hitter's got to be defensive on 2-2, but that was so far outside, he didn't even have to worry about chasing it.
And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still full at 3-2. Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. Rolled foul off to the left, so he stays alive. And my goodness, how about this? He struck out the side in back-to-back innings. Six in a row, and the inning is over. So no runs on no hits. One error in the inning, but a man left stranded. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two, and we are tied 0-0. David Freese will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Well, he's gotten away here early with leaving some of these pitches out over the middle of the plate, especially to start some of these at-bats.
Hit hard but fouled off toward the dugout. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning. So the base is empty here with one away. And here's the ever-dangerous Carlos Beltran. First pitch coming. Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. On a great pitch there as that completely locked him up, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Wow, a real sharp break to this thing. It's a slider. He starts it out over the middle of the plate. The hitter thinks he's got something that he can handle, and then this thing just makes a beeline right for his hands. That is a tough pitch.
In front of the changeup there as this is chopped foul at home plate. And this ball is heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Pitch runs in a little here as this is softly hit out towards short. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Looks like Liriano's got it working now. still nothing. Clint Barmas ready to go here as we begin the third. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. And now a pitch on the way. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. One pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
And I think he'll keep riding that pitch until these guys prove they can do something with it.
Ball two. And he's going to start this inning out the same way he started the previous two. Seven consecutive strikeouts. My word. One away. Francisco Liriano will be the batter. And that's in there for a strike. Bases are empty. One man out. Could we see another strikeout here? It's 0-2 now. Oh, my goodness. Talk about a developing story here. Eight straight strikeouts, and there are two away now.
Boy, he just dominated that at-bat right there. You want to see a power pitcher go right through a guy? This is a three-pitch see-you-later right here. Have a seat.
Jose Tabata will stand in here, hoping to pick up his club's first hit in the contest. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0.
And that's where, if I'm pitching, I just pour a fastball in there. You got to figure he'd be taking to give his pitcher a second or two to get himself together over in the dugout.
2-0 now. Now here's the pitch. Now a swing, and he popped him up. And no ordinary pop-up at that. This is way up there. Craig has got it, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. And we are tied 0-0. Daniel Descalzo will step in now. First pitch coming. First pitch swinging, as this will be a chance for Walker at second. And Walker's throw is in time for out number one. Number 52 steps in now. Here's the first offering. Now the second pitch of the inning is hit on the ground to third. On to first, and very quickly two are gone here in the home third.
Yeah, two pitches, two outs here so far. Offensively, that's not the kind of inning you want in a tie ballgame. You need to make him work at least a little bit out there.
This now is hit to second. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Seven in a row he's set down now as the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. And this is on the outside corner, or thereabouts at least. It's 1-1.
Yeah, A great sell job behind the plate, too. He sort of gently moved that glove back over an inch or two as he was catching that baseball.
Walker lays off there. It's two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field. This ball's got plenty of carry to it, and it is out of here. A solo home run here for Neil Walker. His first homer here in the series, and the Pirates are staked to a 1-0 lead. Andrew McCutchen will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. Changeup called strike one. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
And that's a good spot for that fastball on 0-2. That couldn't have been an easy take.
Now the pitch. And he rings up another one, make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game. Pedro Alvarez will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0.
And if you're wondering, that's 52 pitches now through 3 1/3.
Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Gets under this one as this is hit high and pretty deep out there to center field. And here's Jay to put it away, and that's out number two. Garrett Jones will dig in here. Took a called third strike his first time. Here's the first pitch to him. Changeup too low, and it's 1-0.
Another really close pitch there. He's been around the strike zone quite a bit. You know, sometimes that can be good. Other times, though, it can make you a little too predictable out there.
And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Fastball called strike, 1-2.
He's come back strong since giving up the leadoff home run. Doesn't look like it's fazed him at all.
And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Pirates get one on the Neil Walker home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 Pittsburgh. Matt Carpenter will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Here's a chopper foul off to the right. And this ball's pulled on the ground down the line to first. Over to first is Jones as he'll step on the bag to record the putout.
Yeah. Doesn't look like much has changed here to start this inning either. That's 8 in a row now he's set down.
Alan Craig is at the plate as he looks at ball one.
And I think that might have been a first. The first ball they've taken the entire game. Sound the trumpets.
Got him to swing at a pitch below the knees, 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by him here, 1-2 now. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And here's a fastball that he takes the other way onto fairly deep right. Therefore, it is Bird now as he's got it for out number two.
You just get the sense that he's got it on cruise control out there now. Make it nine in a row, he said.
Matt Holliday will stand in for a second time here as he swings and misses there. It's nothing and one. Fastball swung on and hit on the ground at third. And he is going to reach. It's a base hit. So you can mark that one down as an E5, and I bet he'd like to have that one over. David Freese will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. And this is bounced foul near the secret weapon, Jose Oquendo, in the third base coaching box. This is in the air to center. Does he have another 1-2-3 for the Ledger? He most certainly does. 10 straight he's retired now as that ends the inning. One left for the Cardinals. They still trail 1-0. Marlon Byrd will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. Freeze with it over at third. Freeze is there to put this one away, and it's a very quick out to start the fifth. So the leadoff man's retired now for Russell Martin. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Now the pitch. Fouled back. Here's a swing and a ball hit into the air to left center and shallow. And this is handled easily, so quickly two are gone here to start the fifth. Clint Barmas will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. We'll see Carlos Beltran lead it off when we get back. Last half of the fifth coming up. Bucks out in front, 1-0. There is Carlos Beltran. He'll do battle with Francisco Liriano to get the inning underway. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
1-1 pitch and a nice call for the change. It's 1-2. Hit hard but fouled to the left, and they'll try it again. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
This is one of those guys that you can spend all your time in the video room watching what his pitches look like, but until you get out there and see it firsthand, just have no idea how much his stuff moves around.
And this will be fouled away. No runs, just one hit, one error for the Cardinals to this point. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
You don't want guys to get too comfortable up there, so that's a good idea to run something in tight.
Hit hard on the ground to short. Right there is Varmish. Throw on to first will be in time to get Molina, and that's out number two. Daniel Descalzo will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First offering on the way. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. Oh, and not fielded cleanly here by Walker. And he'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. Number 52 will dig in. 0 for 1 here in this one. First pitch coming. And he squares with two outs and gets it down. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So put another zero on the board as they've been held scoreless through five. Five innings complete. Francisco Liriano will make his way in as he leads things off here in the Pirates' half of the sixth. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. That changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
And even when he's just laying pitches in there, they still swing right through him.
And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
Jose Tabata comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. And this will be bounced foul past a former big league skipper Nick Leyva in that third base coaching box. 1-1 pitch on the way. Ah, and he took something off of it there. It's 1-2. And the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. And he's just rolling right now, and even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame.
One thing we can say about this game, neither team's been afraid to swing a bat. I mean, here we are this late into the ballgame, and we still haven't seen our first walk.
Neil Walker will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup. So you can't let your guard down.
Now a swing and a ball hit foul to first as the first base coach had to do a little skip to Mailou there. And this is fouled back and out of play. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. Two out, nobody on. And he gets under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central. Jay is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Pirates, but they're on top 1-0. John Jay will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. Now here it comes. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2. Now it looks like a right-hander's up and throwing in the Pittsburgh bullpen. And they tie him up in proverbial knots there as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
And sometimes this is all you have to do. Throw a ton of strikes and keep the ball in the yard. It's worked for him so far.
And this one will be fouled back in among the fans. Pitch on the way. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. No runs, two hits, one error for the Cardinals to this point. And he misses there, 1-2. Oh, hit sharply as this is pulled into right. A dive, but he can't come up with it in right as it skips right past him. Around second, he'll try for third. And he is in there at third with a one-out triple.
Well, this is all about risk-reward here. It's spectacular if you get a glove on it. If not, you got to get up off the deck and chase it down.
Alan Craig will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. Swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Yeah, and you know you've got a good changeup when you can come out and throw it first pitch just like he did right there.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
And now this is where you can be just a little bit more selective as a pitcher. You're looking for the strikeout. You certainly don't have to throw a strike in either of the next two pitches, so you got to see if you can get him to chase.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. So a runner at third, two men are out, and here's the left fielder, Matt Holliday. Now a ball swung on and hit high in the air and deep to left center field. This ball has a chance, but that'll hit off the wall in left center.
Well, he's been doing a really good job of working corner to corner, but this is one of the first pitches we've seen that kind of found the middle of the plate, and it's going to cost him a run as this will wind up being an RBI double.
David Freese will stand in now. He struck out and flied out 0-for-2 thus far. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. Now a ball lying toward right center, and he's got himself a base hit. And they're going to hold that runner at third base, as even with two away, they didn't like their chances there.
And you know, Once you see this ball get down in right center, I was thinking this is a run easy. But that's a nice play to get to it quickly and fire it back in. And that'll wind up forcing that runner to hold on at third base.
Carlos Beltran will get another shot. Struck out swinging his last time. Now a ball hit hard but foul as this one forces the third base coach to dance out of danger. Runners on first and third, two away. And here's a swing and a miss as the count goes to 0-2 on Beltran. He's set, now the pitch. And this is on the ground toward the hole. He'll go the short way to Walker at second for the force, and that ends the inning. Cards get one on the RBI double by Matt Holliday. Heart of the order, 3-4-5 coming up to start the seventh, all even at one apiece. Welcome back to Busch Stadium here in St. Louis. Seventh inning coming up now in game one as we take a look here at our game summary through the first six innings so far. Andrew McCutchen will lead it off here in the top of inning number seven. Right there for strike one.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Outside, 2-1. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes. Now on 2-2, where are you going here? And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ballgame.
And there you get a look at his pitches by inning. You can see the count. He's at 83 for the ballgame. Not a huge concern just yet, but he's starting to get up there.
Pedro Alvarez will step in now, 0-2 to this point. Off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes.
Well, we've talked about all the strikeouts. The only side effect is right there, though. He's run up a pretty high pitch count now.
Slider, but that's below the knees, and it's 2-0. One out, nobody on. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. On to first, and there are two down. Garrett Jones will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through. First pitch on the way. And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway. Swung on and missed that time as Jones finds himself behind 0-2.
And he's just running right through these guys. Absolutely worn him down.
The pitch. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
Well, he watched that one all the way in, and it looked like he almost gave up on it. He's pretty lucky that wasn't called strike three.
Now here's the pitch. And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. Swing, and he popped him up over in foul territory back behind third. So they go quietly here in this half inning. On to the bottom of the seventh. Get up and stretch here in St. Louis. All tied at 1-1. Yadier Molina will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame. Slider hit pretty well, but he might have got under it just a bit as this is out toward deep center. McCutchen is under it to tuck this one away, and it's a one pitch out to begin the home half of the seventh. Daniel Descalzo will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. And he'll go after the second pitch of the inning as this is on the ground over to first. Over to first is Jones as he'll step on the bag to record the putout. Number 52 will be the batter, 0-for-2 thus far. Here's a swing and a ground ball. On the first with it is Jones as he steps on the bag to retire the side. Marlon Byrd will get us going now in the top half of the eighth. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now a swing and a ground ball to third. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Russell Martin will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Pulls the string on that one. One strike. Bases are empty. One man out. There's a swing and a miss by Martin as he falls behind now, 0-2. And this is going to be a foul ball in amongst the spectators. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2. Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. Throw on to first, two gone. Clint Barmish will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. And here's the first pitch. Starts him out with a changeup off the plate for ball one. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. A ball hit hard to the left side. And that's in there, so perhaps some life here with two men out. Gabby Sanchez will come on now as a pinch hitter, so that'll spell the end for Francisco Liriano. Yeah. Fastball bounces up to the plate and it's taken for a ball. And this one will be fouled back in among the fans. Look into Molina, now the 1-1. The slider up into the 90s there. It's 1-2. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Full count, 3-2.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that that runner gets a head start from first with two away.
Changeup had him fooled a bit as this is on the ground to third. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. One hit, one left. Home half of the eighth, straight ahead. All tied. Jared Hughes is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. John Jay will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. Bird is there, and that's not the way you want to start the bottom of the eighth. One pitch, one gone. Matt Carpenter will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Now a ball bounced towards the mound. Throw on to the first baseman. Jones is in time. Two away now. Alan Craig will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he fights this one off to stay alive. Now a ball hit high and deep out there to left center field. And he gets there as he had a lot of ground to cover that time, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Cardinals. Score remains deadlocked at 1. Jose Tabata will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far. Ninth inning underway as the first pitch misses for ball 1. And that's right there, and we're even at 1. And now pitch on the way. And this ball runs away for ball 2. 2-1.
That's what you have to do against a big sweeping slider like that. It starts in the zone, and it's probably going to finish out of the zone. So that's a good job, just a layoff.
And he's fallen behind now, 3-1. Off ball 4. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
And in a tie ball game, you don't want to be giving these guys free base runners to start the inning. He's going to need to bounce back from that pronto.
Here comes the Cardinal manager up out of the dugout, out to the mound. And it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. He'll depart with our score tied, and he'll still be accountable for the runner at first, and the best he can do is a no decision in this one. Mark Zepchinski will get the assignment on the mound here as he'll enter with the runner at first and nobody out. Neil Walker stands in as he looks at ball one here.
Yeah, that's just not really good form right there. He's just kind of jabbing at that thing.
Played again, 2-0 now. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. I'm no pitching coach, but it doesn't look like he's finishing his pitches here. That misses high, ball three. Boy, and somewhat shockingly, he's bunting on 3-0, but he gets it down. Throw's going to go on to first, so a perfect sacrifice there is now the go-ahead run moves into scoring position here. Andrew McCutchen will stand in now, and he's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at-bats so far. John Axford will take over in a tie ball game with one gone here in the top of inning number nine. Catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. 0-1 pitch, and he can't make contact on the bender. 0-2.
And after three strikeouts already, you can bet he's going to be pressing up there at the plate, trying to make something happen. And that just might make things worse.
And he struck him out again. So that's the old sombrero there, partner. Four strikeouts in the ballgame.
I'll tell you what, if you're related to this guy right now, you might want to turn away from the screen because this is going to be tough to watch. Here they are, one after another. That's four strikeouts for him, and that's called the Golden Sombrero.
Pedro Alvarez will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot, 0-3 thus far. And he drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing in one.
Not a bad idea to take a look at that one there. Now that you've seen the curveball, you can start to get a better gauge on it. Get a feel for what it looks like coming out of the pitcher's hand.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Jay is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. So they pick up no run on no hits, no errors, and a runner left. On to the bottom of inning number nine. 4, 5, and 6 coming up, all tied at 1-1. Matt Holliday will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Swing and a miss on the sinker, 0-1.
Yeah, and you know, this is a spot where you just have to make him bring the ball down. It's very difficult to do anything positive when it's up that high.
And Holliday will not offer at that point. It's a ball and a strike. Fouled straight back. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. And this ball will be chopped foul. A drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. It's a solo home run for Matt Holliday. And with one swing of the bat, this ball game is over.
Talking high drama here in the playoffs. A walk-off win here in the final at bat, and this place is going crazy right now.
In the postseason, as you know, you need players coming up big, and this guy certainly did that. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and prove your mettle. I think his performance here was by far the big key to this ball game.
So that brings us to the conclusion in this one. For EK Psycho and the rest of our crew, this is Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, log on to theshownation.com. The Cardinals win it 2-1.